name is Olga Stuenkel. I'm Assistant Professor of International Relations at the Fundação Getulio Vargas in São Paulo. Brazil has a dominant regional role. It's 50% of GDP in the population in South America. So its sphere of influence is largely confined to the region. But it has, in some instances, tried to also strengthen democracy in other parts. For example, by strengthening democratic stability in Haiti, but also in Guinea-Bissau. So there's some instances. I would say over the past 4 years, there's also been a lot of criticism saying that Brazil could have been much more active. So in that sense, I think we've seen a more engaged Brazil over the past decade, but the last president has been quite passive. I think for Brazil, it's really important to maintain regional stability and ideally democratic stability as well, not only to maintain the political stability of each country, but also to strengthen the democratic quality of its neighboring countries. And I think there Brazil has not been up to task. I think it has been very good at promoting stability, not so much at assuring that the quality of democracy is adequate. Cooperation between Brazil and the EU, or Brazil and the United States regarding democracy support is actually very limited. Also because the whole concept of democracy promotion and support is not uncontested in Brazil. So I think it is important when we talk about cooperation to talk about more technical terms that are not as political sounding, or which you know, don't generate problems in the region. So I think talking about good governance, for example, is a possibility. Talking about transparency, cooperating on issues of how to integrate social movements into the political process are ways to strengthen that cooperation, which at this point doesn't really exist yet in an organized way.